Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'll show you how to use the Type on a Path tool in Adobe Illustrator. We'll work with each of the shapes that you see here on my screen, and when you're finished, you'll be able to type on any path that you come across in any of your projects. Now let's move to a different document where I have some of these shapes already set up. Now this green stroke is what we'll be using first. I'll select it, and it's nothing more than an 85-point stroke that has a green color applied to it. And let me show you how I got those round edges. Come over to the Properties panel and click on the word stroke. And right here under cap, you can choose this center icon, and this is going to give you a round cap on both edges of your stroke. So let's close that out, and we'll move to the left toolbar and press down on the type tool to get this flyout menu. And here the third line down is the type on a path tool. I'll select this, and you see my cursor changes to a text cursor with a wavy line running through it. That is the type on a path tool. Now the thing to know about this tool is that once you apply it to a path of any kind, Illustrator is going to remove the attributes of that path and replace it with placeholder text. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to just click here, and now I've got my placeholder text, but Illustrator has removed the green color, the 85 points, and that cap edge. But I didn't want to lose that green squiggly line. I merely wanted to add the text to it. So we've got to back up. I'll undo the move with the keyboard shortcut Command Z. And the first thing I've got to do is make a copy of that green squiggly line. I move over to the Layers panel so you can see what's happening. I'll twirl open the green path layer. And with it selected, I'm going to make a copy of it. I'll use the keyboard shortcut Command C, and then I'm going to paste it in place with the keyboard shortcut Shift Command V. And you can see that I've added an additional green squiggly line. I know that's not a very professional title for it, but that's what it is. I'm going to move over to this left column, and I'm going to hide the layer that's on bottom by clicking on the eyeball, and then I'll click in this column, and we're going to lock this layer so I don't accidentally move it. Now I'm going to be working with the top green squiggly line. It's selected here, and it's selected on the artboard. I have my Type on a Path tool, and now when I come over and click on the path, I'm not concerned that all I have is placeholder text because I still have a copy of the line here in the Layers panel. And with the placeholder text selected, I can just type right over it with the words I want. So I'm going to say here, you can type in the center of a thick line. All right, now I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and you'll see that we do have our text right along that path that we had before, but I've also got some additional lines here. I have a line on the left, and if I hover over it, you see the icon that's underneath my cursor. It has an arrow pointing to the right, and this means that all of my text has got to be to the right of this left margin. Then if I move to the right and hover here on this right text margin, the icon under my cursor has an arrow pointing to the left, which means that all of the text has got to be to the left of the right text margin. And then we have this center line. This is called the center bracket. It's got an arrow pointing up. And with this center bracket, there are a couple of things I can do. I can flip the text by grabbing it and dragging it on the other side of the path, and I can also move it around, although this is not the most efficient way to move your text around. I'm going to undo the move, keyboard shortcut Command Z, and I'll show you some other ways that you can move your text. I can grab hold of the right text margin, and I can drag the lines here. I can grab this left and move it here. But notice now I've shortened the spacing between the left and the right margins, and Illustrator gives me this little red square with a plus in it, which tells me I have some overset type. Now, when you're working with a text box and you click on this little box, Illustrator attaches the extra text to your cursor. And if you click on the artboard, it's going to create a duplicate text box, or in our case, it's going to create a duplicate curve and place the overset text there. Well, that's not what I wanted at all, so I'm going to undo the move, keyboard shortcut Command Z, and I've got to get rid of the text that's attached to my cursor. So I'll come back over and click on the selection tool again, and I'll grab hold of the right text margin and move it to the right, and I'm going to move this left text margin over here like so. Now there are a lot of ways you can format your text. Let's move over to the properties panel and I'll show you that we can align it to the center by just clicking here, and that moves the text between the left text margin and the right, or I can click on align to the right and that moves my text all the way to the right. I can change the color of it by just clicking on the fill color icon. Let's change this to green. I can change the style of the character. Let's make this bold. And we can change where the text is placed along this path. The default setting places the text on top of the path right along the baseline. There are two ways to access the dialog box that's going to allow us to change that. The first one is come up to type, down to type on a path, over and down to type on a path options. This opens up this little dialog box. I'm going to cancel this out and show you the other way to access the dialog box. I'll go back to the left toolbar and I'm going to double click this icon, and that opens up the type on a path options dialog box as well. I'll click preview and let me show you what all of these options are. The first one is pretty self-explanatory and it's simply to flip the text. We've already seen another way to do that with the center bracket. I'll uncheck flip, and next let's look at effect. Rainbow is the default setting and I almost always leave it set on rainbow, but there's a pull down menu. I'll just show you what the other options are. Here is skew, 3D ribbon, stair step, and gravity. I'm going to move back to rainbow. Next, we have align to path, and the default setting is the baseline. But if you want your text to be below the path without flipping it, then you choose ascender. If you want it to be above the path, not on the baseline, but actually above the path, then you choose descender. Now, it seems like it ought to be the other way around, but it's not. Above is descend and below is ascend. Next, we have center. And when you choose center, you're going to have your text applied right to the very center of that baseline. And that's where I'm going to leave our text for this project. Then finally, we have spacing. I always leave this set on auto, but let me just show you that you can type in a negative number if you want your entire text to move to the right. And if you want it to move to the left, you type in a positive number. We'll just leave this set on auto and say okay. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. I'll move over to the layers panel. I'll unhide our green squiggly line and let's unlock this layer as well. And then move back to the properties panel. And I want to make some changes here because I want this text to fill this line up. So I'm going to increase the size and I'm going to move our left text margin all the way to the left and the right text margin all the way to the right. And then I'll choose to align the text to center. And we can increase this a little bit more here. And I'm going to leave it there. And that's how you work with an open path. Now let's move to a closed path. And remember, we've got to make a copy if we want to keep the object, which I do. I'll move over to the layers panel and let's close the green path layer and twirl open this orange circle. I'm going to make a copy using the keyboard shortcut Command C, and I'll paste it in place with the keyboard shortcut Shift Command V. And here we have an additional copy set up. I'll hide the lower layer and lock it so it doesn't move, and then we'll work with this selected ellipse layer. I'll get the Type on a Path tool and click on the path, and Illustrator leaves me with some placeholder text. I'm going to type in, this is the top of the circle, and get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and I want to make the text a little smaller, so I'll move to the properties panel, and it's already selected, so all I have to do is type in a value or use this flyout menu. So let's type in 36 and press the return key. And now what do? I want this text to be at the top of the circle. I have the left and the right text margin here, and I have the center bracket here. And we know we can move the text with the center bracket. So I'm going to press down with my mouse, and I'm going to drag to the left, and I'm looking for a center line, and here it is. This is Smart Guides showing me that the center bracket is lined up with the center of the circle. So I'll now release my mouse, and my text is perfectly centered at the top of the circle. If you do this and you don't see a line appear, go up to View, down to Smart Guides, and click it on here, or use the keyboard shortcut Command U to toggle the Smart Guides on and off. Now, while I do believe using the center bracket to manipulate your text on a circle is the easiest way, I want to point out you can also move the text around by moving the right and the left text margins. It's just a little more tedious because you've got to figure out which one is which. Now, I'm going to hover over the line on the right. My icon underneath the cursor shows an arrow to the left. That means this is the right text margin. So I'll grab it and drag it to the right. Again, I can use Smart Guides to center that up. Then I'll come back down here, hovering here. The icon shows the arrow to the right, which means this is the left text margin. I'm going to grab it and drag it over until I see I'm centered again, and this is the other way where you can move your text and center it at the top of the circle. Both ways give me the same results. I'll undo the move, keyboard shortcut Command Z, and Command Z. Okay, so I have my text at the top of the circle, but I also want text at the bottom of the circle. The easiest way I have found to do that is to simply copy the top. So I'm going to open up the layers panel so you can follow me along here. I have the text selected. I'll make a copy using the keyboard shortcut Command C, and then I'll paste that copy in place using the keyboard shortcut Shift Command V. And you can see in the layers panel, we have a duplicate of the text. Well, with one of these layers selected, I'll get the rotate tool, keyboard shortcut R, and I'll hold down the shift key so that as I rotate, I'm snapping at 45 degree increments. And when I have 180 degrees, I'm going to release my mouse. And now I have text at the top and at the bottom, and you can see this reflected in the layers panel. Now, the problem is that the text on the bottom is upside down, hard to read. I don't like that. So I want to flip it. Well, let me get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and I can just grab it and flip it like this. And that takes care of having it right side up. But now this text is on the inside of the circle. This text is on the outside of the circle, and that's not going to work either. But we know that changing the alignment is super simple. All we have to do is go to the left toolbar, double click on the Type on a Path tool to open up the Type on a Path options dialog box. The layer that's selected is the text at the bottom of the circle. I want this text to be on the outside of the circle underneath the baseline, so I'm going to have to choose the ascender option. I'll check preview, and then under align to path, I'm going to choose ascender and say okay. and the text is nicely placed on the outside of the circle. Now I want to change the upper circle, so I'm going to select the upper text and I'll double click to open the options dialog box again. This time we want our text to be above the baseline, so let's click preview and move to align to path and choose descender and say okay. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. The text is perfectly placed where we want it, but I do need to change the words on the bottom of the circle. So I'll select the bottom layer and I'm gonna grab hold of this text and just type bottom here. Then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. Go back to the layers panel and unhide the ellipse and unlock it. And click on the artboard and we see that everything is properly placed exactly where I wanted it. Now this final example is using a closed path as well. I started out with a rectangle and then I used the curvature tool, which is on the left toolbar. The keyboard shortcut is shift accent and I just grabbed the lines to create different waves. I'll undo that move, keyboard shortcut command Z, and the first thing I'll do is make a copy. Let me twirl this layer open. I'll use the keyboard shortcut command C to make a copy and to paste it in place, keyboard shortcut shift command V. Then I'll hide the bottom layer and lock it, and we'll work with this upper layer. I'll get the type on a path tool and click on the path, but look what's happened. Illustrator has placeholder text around this whole thing, and that's not what I want. I just want to be able to type on these upper waves. So I'm gonna undo that move, keyboard shortcut, command Z, and we're gonna make a little revision before we apply that type on a path tool. I'll get the scissors tool, keyboard shortcut C. It's on the left toolbar and typically it's showing, but if you have the eraser tool showing, you can just get the flyout menu and choose the scissors tool here. I'm going to click on the far left upper anchor and the far right upper anchor, and then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and click on the bottom part of the object and then press the delete key. Now I can get the type on a path tool and click on the path and Illustrator gives me the placeholder text that I want. And all I have to do is type. So here I have the top of the waves, and then to create the text that was inside the waves, I'm gonna make a copy, keyboard shortcut, command C. Paste it in place, keyboard shortcut shift command V, and then with that selected, I'll come over and double click on the icon to get the type on a path options dialog box. I'll check preview and then we'll choose ascender and say okay. And then I want this other text to be above the baseline, so I'll select it. Go back over and double click to open up the options box again, click preview and change this to descender, say okay. Let's select this bottom piece, change this to a white fill, and then I'll go to the layers panel and unhide the blue. Get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and click on the artboard to see it did exactly what I wanted. Well, I do hope you've enjoyed this video and learned some things about using the type on a path tool in Adobe Illustrator. I do want to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so that you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.